Welcome to this new episode. In this episode, we will discuss about the central bank master maintenance process. So let us go into the presentation and discuss the bank master maintenance process in detail. So today we will see what is bank master data and what is the current bank master maintenance process and what is the target solution we try to achieve, and then do, you know, we can also use workflow driven roles and responsibilities if required. And then we also see questions and answers, and then maybe you will use this during your workshop meetings. And then the effort estimation for the implementation of bank master data, and then the implementation strategy. Yeah. So what is bank master data? So the bank masters are stored in the table called as BNK. And then we also call this table as a bank directory. And there are two set of fields in the bank master data. One is address fields and another one is a control data fields. And then we also have already bank master checks within the SAP system. And then the bank master can be maintained in the S4 system using the SAP standard Fiori apps, or you can also use LSMW. Or on a migration cockpit, or you can use a mass transaction, or you can also integrate with a third party system. These are all already available in the S4 system. So we call the bank master data as a bank directory, and we have two bank master data within the S4 system. One is a house bank and another one is a normal bank master data. So house bank is used internally by the companies to post internal expenses, so I don't think it makes sense to centralize because every local system have their own house banks. But it really makes sense to centralize the bank master data, which is used in the business partner, so you can post your you can use it to pay the vendor or get the money from the customer. So this is the current bank master maintenance process in the system, that the bank master files are usually received from the third party systems like a SWIFT and then manually loaded in the ERP S4 systems. Our bank masters are manually updated using the standard TCOs, and bank masters are created while creating customer vendor master data by the local steward. So if you go to the T-code PP, and the local stewards try to create customer or vendor, they will update also the bank master data, and when they try to save it, it will also create the corresponding bank master data in the backend. Yeah. So what is the disadvantage? It is completely a disintegrated approach. Yeah, so it increases the complexity and also very tedious and time consuming to maintain the bank master data in each system separately. And it increases the chances of creating redundant master data. So, currently the users are maintaining in, every systems. So that's the reason we are, talking about centralizing this bank master data. So we are, looking at how the bank master data are currently maintained. That means they are maintained in separately in each system. So therefore, it increases the chances of creating redundant master data. And maybe some bank master data is missing in some system, it is not. And then the end users, of course, need access and training to different systems. And this is the target solution. The target solution is we wanted to centralize the bank master data in the MDG system. So you can decide whether you wanted to maintain the bank master through MDG change request process or without MDG change request process, and use MDG system to centralize the bank master data. So it is purely your business requirements that whether to use MDG change request process or without. If you don't use MDG change request process, SAP provides standard Fiori apps to maintain at the bank master data manually, so that you can give access to your end user to update the bank master data. So you need to analyze what is the benefit of using MDG, and is that benefit really demanded by the customer, or that benefit is very less. And because if you use MDG, the implementation effort is a little high, So you need to analyze all these things, and most of the customers I worked for, they really don't need this change request process because the files are always coming from the other system and they're on a monthly basis and then loaded into the MDG backend system and then distributed to the target system. This much process is sufficient for them, and then in some cases one or two times on a monthly basis they try to update some of the existing bankmaster data. It's very rare, I mean less than 10 bankmaster data. So in such case they really don't prepare implementing the MDG, but rather they are okay to update using the Pure React. So you really need to analyze the requirements of the customer and then see if they really don't want to use much of the MDG governance process. Then you can completely ignore the change request based bankmaster maintenance. Rather, instead provide Pure React so that they can, in case if they wanted to update bankmaster manually, then they can use it. So in the central bankmaster process, either using MDG process or without MDG process, but it is in the MDG system. Yeah, so we can also use MDG as a backend to maintain the bankmaster data. So normally data comes from either SWIFT, third party system or non-SAP system, or it could also be a SAP system, or it could be a global application system, and you can use middleware PI, and then the PI sends the data to the MDG, and then MDG replicates the data to all the target system. And in case if the customer wanted to maintain some of the bankmaster data manually, you could, if you have created a change request process, they could update it through change request process. Otherwise, they will update using the Fiori apps. And as you see, the black ones are automatic process and the red one is a manual process. So all these things are fully automated. This is the target solution we try to achieve, that central creation and maintenance of bankmaster data. And then we wanted a single trusted view of the bankmaster data. And of course, we wanted the enhanced transparency and then the less duplication. So what is the benefits of using this central bankmaster maintenance process? So the bankmaster received from the SIF system and automatically loaded in the S4 system. This complete process is automated, so less manual intervention. And then the bankmaster also manually updated either using a Fiori apps or change request process. So still we can able to provide such manual maintenance to the end user if they required. And then if you are using MDG, of course you can use a DQM tool, mass processing tool, but it is all purely a custom solution. And also you can use a rule based workflow using in the change request based bankmaster process. And then if you are using DRF, then you can put a lot of filter condition to selectively replicate certain bankmaster to different system and not to some systems. And then the overall, it reduces the labor cost because now you don't really want to really need to train people in a different system. You just need to train maybe one or two people to maintain the central system, so it considerably reduces the overall labor cost. Okay, so the next is workflow driven roles and responsibility. So if you have used a MDG change request based process for the bankmaster maintenance, then you can use MDG rule based workflows. So here the requester looks for the bankmaster data. If he finds the data already in the system, then he initiates the change process. Otherwise, he initiates the creation process, and then he finalizes his process and then send it to the reviewer. Reviewer reviews it, and if there is a correction required, he send it back to the requester. Otherwise, he finalizes the CR. And then once he finalizes, the data will go to the approver. He reviews once again the data, and then he finalizes the data. Once he finalizes, the data is created in the backend system, also replicated to all the target system. In case if some issue with change request, then it will be assigned to the fallback user to check the errors and then reactivate the CM. So if you use workflow driven roles and responsibilities, then you need to think about a global role or what kind of role you need to assign to the user in the MDG system. So we recommend creating one global role and then country specific role. Most of the time The bank master data is created based on the countries, and different country people maintain the bank master for different countries. So you can create one global role which gives access to complete bank master data and also have an access to distribute the master data using the fury decodes. And then you can create one role for every country, and then you can provide access, edit access to only that particular country. And then you can think about whether to provide display access to all the countries or not necessary. And then the questions. So all these questions you need to ask during your fit gap analysis meeting, and then you need to collect all the requirements. And let us go through some of the questions. So we need to ask, do you need any special conditions or default values? And then do you need any emails after the data is successfully uploaded from Swift or a BAP T code? And do you need any cleansing on the existing master data? And sometimes I saw that they are using kind of a special report for Chinese banks. So this also you need to see and incorporate this in the MDG system. And then do we need a local role for all countries or only certain countries? So you need to discuss about rules, roles and responsibility. That means who will manage the bank master data within the central within the MDG system. And then KT, all these things you need to discuss with the both the functional business consultant from the client side, also together with the technical consultant and functional consultant. And then this is the effort estimation. So we have to estimate for the functional team and also for the technical team for all these activities you plan to perform. And next is the project implementation strategy. And this is how you approach the project. You will be having a project preparation phase, blueprinting and validation phase, and then build and testing phase, and then final preparation and go live phase, and finally the hypercare support phase. So during the project preparation phase, you will prepare the project plan, you onboard the resource, also you do the project kickoff, and then you also do this set up the governance process, standards and templates, and also you will make sure the offshore connectivity, the technical team is from India or some other countries like such as Middle East or Europe, or it doesn't matter. And then the solvent process, such as change management and the infrastructure management and program management. And then in the blueprinting phase, you will define the business MDG business process. Also, you will define the rise up objects, and then you will prepare detailed training plan for various user groups, and then prepare the user role document in consultation with your customer team. And then you analyze all your documents and get it signed from the respective team. And in the build phase, you do the baseline configurations, and then you develop in the system. And then you plan your test plans. You create a UAT test cases and test scripts. And then you will perform the UAT testing. And then you will plan for the go live in the final preparation phase, and then you deliver all the user training and user training, and then prepare the production system. And then in this phase, the UAT is completely finished, and you also get the UAT business sign up from the customers. And then finally, you there also data migration and replication, and then you move all the changes to the go live. And then you will provide, you will prepare the cutover activities for all these things. And then you will set the objects in the production system. And at the end, you have to provide the go live support for 2 or 3 weeks. So these are the activity you will be executing for most of the project. It's the same thing, but so in the build and testing phase, you have to decide whether to use a linear model or that is the ASAP model, or the activate methodology, which is more of a agile based. So that you have to plan whether you want to go with the agile based, that is sprint based development, or the linear development. So in the coming videos, we will see all these things in detail, how to approach the implementation project, how to approach the country rollout project, how to approach the upgrade and the conversion projects. For all these things, we will see the implementation strategy and how to achieve the better success with the customer. Thank you so much.